Hello all, we'll see about cell and its structure. What is a cell? Cell is a structural and functional unit of living body. Group of cells make tissue and group of tissues make organ and group of organs make organ system. Structure of a cell. Structure of cell contains cell membrane and nucleus and cell containing cytoplasm. Cytoplasm contains 80% of water and others are other substances and organelles. And now we'll see about cell membrane. What we follow now is fluid mosaic model. It was presented by Singer and Nicholson. A cell membrane is a phospholipid bilayer with proteins, lipids, carbohydrates. Proteins are 55%. They are integral and peripheral protein. Integral protein is also known as transmembrane protein. And lipids are 40%, they are phospholipids and cholesterol, and carbohydrates are 5%, they are glycoproteins or also proteoglycans. The lipids have a head and a tail. The head is hydrophilic in nature and the tail is hydrophobic in nature. And functions of cell membrane. Cell membrane separates the extracellular compartment and intracellular compartment. It helps in protection, absorption, excretion, maintenance of shape and size of the cell. It also helps in exchange of gases. Now we'll see about cell organelles. The cell organelles are divided into membrane-bound organelles and non-membrane-bound organelles. The non-membrane-bound organelles are ribosomes and cytoskeleton. Other organelles are membrane-bound. Now we'll see about membrane-bound organelles. First one is endoplasmic reticulum. It is divided into rough endoplasmic reticulum and smooth endoplasmic reticulum. The rough endoplasmic reticulum contains ribosomes. They help in synthesis of proteins. The smooth endoplasmic reticulum helps in synthesis of lipids and steroids. Now we'll see about Golgi apparatus. The produced proteins in the endoplasmic reticulum are transported to Golgi apparatus. In Golgi apparatus, the proteins are processed, packed, labeled, and delivered to the target. Now lysosome. Lysosome is also known as suicidal bag. It will contain pool of enzymes, which helps in degradation of the worn-out organelles and macromolecules. Peroxisomes. Peroxisomes, the major function is to detoxify metabolic waste, and it also helps in lipid peroxidation, that is the breakdown of heavy fatty chains. Centrosome, its function is to organize the microtubules and it helps in the cell division. Now we'll see about mitochondria. Mitochondria, it has two membranes, an outer membrane and inner membrane. The inner membrane is folded into cristae. Both the membranes contain a large amount of enzymes which helps in certain functions, that is biochemical oxidation of certain compounds, which results in synthesis of ATP, breakdown of ATP releasing energy, and it also contains caspases which helps in apoptosis. Now nucleus. Nucleus is the control unit of the cell. The components of nucleus: it has nuclear membrane, it has nucleolus, it has nucleoplasm. The nucleus contains DNA, RNA. They are organized into chromatin, and further chromatin condensation makes chromosome. Function of the nucleus is it stores genetic information, protein synthesis, it controls the cell activities and cell division. Now we'll see about non-membrane bound organelles. They are ribosomes and cytoskeleton. First we'll see about ribosomes. Humans are ATS subunit. It is divided into 60S large unit and 40S small unit. It occurs as free ribosomes and ribosomes which are attached to rough endoplasmic reticulum. The function of ribosome is to synthesis of protein. Now cytoskeleton. The major function of cytoskeleton is determination of cell shape and stability of the cell shape and strength of the cell, and it also helps in cellular movements. these functions are occurring through certain protein structures called microtubules, intermediate filaments, and microfilaments. Microtubules are globular protein. It has tubulin protein, and it has an alpha and beta subunit. And intermediate filaments are fibrous protein. Examples are keratin in epithelial cells and desmin in muscle fibers. And in microfilaments, these are non-tubular contractile proteins. They are actin and myosin. Actin is more than myosin. Now we'll see about cell adaptation and cell death. Before that, we'll see about the summary of the organelles. Cellular adaptation and cell death. The following are the cell adaptations: atrophy, hypertrophy, hyperplasia, metaplasia, and dysplasia. Atrophy is the decrease in size of the cell. Hypertrophy is increase in the size of the cell. Hyperplasia is increase in number of the cell. And metaplasia is conversion of one form of cell to another form. Example, squamous cell is converted into a columnar cell. And dysplasia means it is also called as atypical hyperplasia. And the growth of the cell is improper. Now we'll see about cell death. There are three types: apoptosis, necrosis, and autophagy. Apoptosis is programmed cell death. It is because of caspase is released by mitochondria, and this caspase condenses and fragments the cell, and it is made into apoptotic bodies. Necrosis is unprogrammed cell death. This results in enzymatic digestion of the cellular components, and there's leakage of cell contents. Autophagy is self-digestion of cells. That's it. Thank you.